A very good morning to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. This is Rajiv and today we are going to make this chicken animation in PowerPoint 2016. Let's take a preview first. And here we have 15 objects that I will show you through selection pane by clicking on the home tab, then clicking the select drop down button and then clicking on selection pane. And here you can see that 13 objects has been used in this animation and there are a lot of sub objects in each object because this entire character has been designed using the shape tools, as you can see that. So let me undo this, and a total 15 animations has been used. And let me show you by clicking on the animation tab and then clicking on animation pan, and here you can see that 15 animations has been used in this entire scene. And there is one very interesting thing here, that on 13 objects a same animation has been used, which is spin animation. As you can see here, on these 13 objects spin animation has been used. Only on 2 objects the motion path has been used. So let's start by deleting all these animation by selecting the first one, then holding the shift key and then selecting the last one, then hitting the delete key from the keyboard. Now first we will animate the sickles, and I select this one, and this one is sickle number 3. And to animate this sickle, I go to add animation drop down button and apply the spin animation. And all the animation in this presentation will be start with previous, and apply a duration around 0.25 seconds. And now I open the effect options by right clicking on this animation and then clicking on effect options. I don't want any smoothness for this animation, so I will not change the value of this one. And I want to rotate this sickle to 8 degree clockwise. And I want this sickle to reverse back to its original position after animation. So it will rotate to 8 degree, then will reverse back to its original position. And in the timing tab, I will apply repeat until end of slide, because I want this sickle to continuously rotate and reverse back to its original location and do that until the slide ends. Hit the OK button. Now to animate the rest of two sickles, what you can do quickly is that you can select this one, then click on animation painter twice and then start clicking on the sickle number 2 and then on sickle number 3. Now what you can do, you can open the effect option of sickles 2, and here what you only need to do is to change the rotation degree. And I want to rotate this sickle number 2 to 5 degree counterclockwise, and rest of the option will remain same. And we will do the same for sickle number 1, and I want to rotate this sickle to 5 degree clockwise and rest of the option will remain same. Now close the animation painter by clicking on it once again. Now see the slideshow. That's look good. Now we will animate the swaddle of the chicken, and that is this object, and you can see that in the selection pane, and it has the same spin effect. So I will copy that animation from the sickle by clicking on animation painter and then clicking on the swaddle. And what we will do here, we open the effect options, and I want to rotate this swaddle to 5 degree counterclockwise with no smoothness, with the auto reverse, and I want to apply a duration of 0.50 seconds to this swaddle, and I also want to repeat it until end of the slide. Now we will copy the same animation to the rest of the objects, and so that I select the swaddle, double click on the animation painter and then start clicking on, first of all I will click on wing bar, which is this one. Then I click on right leg, then on left leg, then on chicken comb, then on hackle, then on mouth, then on upper beak, then on upper beak, which is this one, and I click here. That's nice. And then on the lower beak, which is this one, red one. Now close the animation printer by clicking on it once again. And what we will do now, we will change the effect option of all these animations after the soodle. And so for the wing bar, I apply the same 5 degree counterclockwise rotation without smoothness, with auto reverse, with the duration of 0.50 seconds, and repeat until end of slide. And for the right leg, I want to rotate the right leg to 50 degree clockwise without any smoothness, with auto reverse, and same duration, and repeat until end of slide. And for the left leg, I want to rotate this left leg to 50 degree counterclockwise, and the rest of the option will remain same. For the chicken comb, we want to spin this chicken comb to 10 degree clockwise, and the rest of option will remain same. And for the hackle, I want to rotate this hackle to 10 degree clockwise, and without smoothness, with auto reverse, and rest of the option will remain same. And for the mouth, I want to spin the mouth to 5 degree clockwise. Okay. And for the upper beak, I want to rotate the upper beak to 8 degree clockwise. And finally, for the lower beak, I want to rotate the lower beak to 8 degree clockwise. Now let's see the preview. And that's what it takes to animate this chicken. And finally, let me show you one more thing here, that the upper beak has been designed. The upper and lower beak are the same objects. If you look them carefully, you can see that this is lower beak and this is upper beak, but the upper beak is the same object, which is hidden by using the no fill and no outline options. As you can see that this upper beak, if you fill the color here, then you can notice that this is the same object, but the rest of the part of this object has been hidden. And I did this because it will make it easy to animate the upper beak, and by showing only the beak and hiding all the rest of the parts of the upper beak. So I undo this. And finally, if you see the slideshow, I want this comb to move a little bit diagonally up to match with the hackle. And I also want to animate the shadow. And first of all, we will animate the shadow. And for this, I select the shadow, and on the shadow I will apply grow shrink effect with previous, with the duration of 0.50 seconds. Open the effect option. You can also open the effect option by double clicking on any effect. And here I want to grow it to 125% without any smoothness, with auto reverse, and I want to repeat this effect until end of the slide. Okay. And for the comb, I select the comb and add animation motion pass, and I want to apply here diagonal upright. Now I close the selection pane and zoom out a little bit and adjust the path. Adjust the path to right a little here. That's it. And open the effect option. No smoothness, with auto reverse, with previous duration of 0.50 seconds and I want to repeat it until the end of the slide. Okay, let's see the slideshow. Okay, let's look good. And finally, I also want the lower beak to move a little bit here, and for that I also apply the motion path, and this time I use the up one. And now we will adjust the path length. And for that I move it to right here. And I want to play it with previous with the duration of 50 seconds, 0.50 seconds. With the effect option no smoothness, auto reverse, and repeat until end of slide with the duration of 0.50 seconds. Let's see the preview. Okay, that's look good. And finally, what you can do in the end, that you can place a few houses or a background picture that will move to the left. And to move it left, as you can see that I have applied the left motion path, or you can select that picture and go to the add animation, more motion paths, apply a left motion path, adjust the length of the path. You can hold down the shift key when moving the paths, then it will go straight. And I want to stop it right here. Play it with previous, and how much fast or slow you want to move the houses will depend on the duration that you will apply here. I want these houses to take 15 seconds to cross over. And then open the effect options. I don't want any smoothness here. Don't want to auto reverse it, and want to repeat it until end of the slide. So finally we see the preview. Okay, let me send these houses to back of the chicken, and for that I go to the format tab, and here I apply send to back. So before I end the lesson, let me quickly tell you one more thing, that if you want to reduce the size of this chicken, reduce or increase the size of this chicken, then there is no option in PowerPoint to change the object sizes after you have animated them. Because if you will select this entire chicken and group it to reduce the size, and you can do reduce the size easily by holding the Ctrl Alt Shift keys and then dragging and dropping the chicken, but as you can see that all the animations has been deleted because PowerPoint does not allow different animation on grouped objects. So there is no solution to this, so you must take care of the size before you start animating an object. So what you can do here is, first of all, select the entire chicken and make a duplicate of it by copy and pasting, and move it to right here. And I will group this chicken, and I go to the format tab, click the group drop down button, and then click on group. Now I will reduce the size, and now I will ungroup this chicken and will replicate the effect of this chicken to this one. And for that I select the comb first like this, or I select, you can also select the sickles first, then go to the animation tab, then click on animation painter once, and then click on this sickle. And you have to repeat these steps to animate all the other objects. Like I select the sickles 2, then go to the animation painter, click on sickles 2 of this chicken, and so on. So I quickly do this. And for upper and lower beak, I will zoom a little bit. That's it. Now you can select this chicken and delete it, and then select this chicken and place it to the desired position. And now let's see the slideshow. So I hope you will find this video informative and interesting. If you have learned something new, then let me know by leaving a comment. You can share this video with your friends and don't forget to hit the like button. Thanks for watching and have a good day.